I need your help. Meet me at the old cinema downtown. Please, hurry.
Thank you so much for coming. My name's Lily, and my fiancé, Adam, works with you at Fear for Sale magazine. He's told me so much about you. I knew that if anyone could figure out what's going on, it would be the famous journalist that solved the mysteries of McEnroy Manor and in the town of Sunnyvale. Everything I'm about to tell you will sound very strange, maybe even impossible, but I swear it's all true. In case something happens to me, would you please record our conversation? Could you please tape our conversation? Could you please tape our... A few weeks ago, Adam received two tickets to a private screening for a new movie at this theater. The weird thing is that this theater has been closed for years. I didn't want to go, but Adam loves movies and is a talented writer, so he came by himself. Since that night, he's been missing, and no one, not even the police, can find him. Then, just a few days ago, I got another ticket addressed to me, to come to tonight's screening. There is no way I am stepping in that theater. I feel absolutely powerless. I beg you, please, find my Adam. Here, take my ticket. I know I'm putting you in danger by asking you to go in there, but I don't know where else to turn.
Are you going to see the movie too? Oh, I've never been to a movie premiere before. Sorry, I gotta go. I don't want to miss the previews. They're the best part of the movie, you know.
Your ticket, please. This is not your ticket. You are not the girl of whom he so often speaks. No matter, the time grows near, and all is...
Isn't much time. My name is Adam, and I'm being held against my will. Somewhere, and I'm not alone. We need your help. But beware the projectionist. I think think someone's here. I have to go. Remember, stay away from the projectionist!
Thank you. Thank you.